Hey everyone, welcome back. My name's Greg, and today we're talking about Appian RPA and low-code Excel actions. Now, when we're utilizing RPA, we definitely want to use it to be able to replace the work of those highly repetitive tasks, allowing our employees to focus on the more interesting things. Now, in this video, we're focusing on Excel actions. So I'm going to explain a use case, talk about how Appian can help, and then build and execute a robotic task. Let's first talk about our use case. Acme Pharmaceuticals is an international healthcare organization with a complex finance workflow. The finance department uses Appian for their forecasting and accruals workflow, which has improved the process. But there was still a part of the workflow that wasn't running optimally. This part involved manually formatting Excel reports to match the specific needs of the finance team. Each day, a project analyst would download several large files, run a script to format the original data, then upload the new reports to the Appian application. This part of the process was time-consuming and resource-intensive. So, what could they do? Acme Pharmaceutical needs to implement Appian RPA to automate the work of that project analyst, freeing them up to perform more complex tasks. They can build a robotic task that gets a spreadsheet file previously uploaded to the Appian application, runs a macro to format the data, and re-uploads the file back to Appian. Let's get started. All right, so let's take a look at our robotic task. Now, we've already created it so that way we can kind of show you each and every step of how we are creating the solution for this use case. So let's dive into each area here. As you'll notice, we already have a setup, a main, and a cleanup section. Now the setup portion is to get the document downloaded from Appian and then get the name of the document saved to a different variable, right? So first we have a download file action, a download document action, and it is specifically downloading an Excel workbook. Now this workbook is in a constant, but this workbook could be anywhere. The point is that it's gonna get that document wherever it lives, download it to the virtual machine, and then it's going to get the name of that file or create the name of that file. In this case, using an evaluate expression action. Now this action is very similar to a script task in a process model. So we have the expression here that's going to get the name of the document and then save that name to Excel file name. Finally, we move down to the main section. Now in the main section, we're going to open the Excel workbook as well as a template workbook. Now this template workbook is a macro enabled template. It already has a macro installed or uploaded into the file. And we're going to take information from one Excel, paste it into our macro Excel, and then run that macro. Okay, and that's exactly what you see us doing here. We're going to open the macro template workbook first, and we incorporate a file path of where that macro workbook exists. So this is just find the file path, copy, paste it here. Then we need to open the Excel file workbook, the one that we downloaded. So again, we incorporate the file path here. In this case, it's already saved in my process variable Excel file path. So imagine both of these workbooks are now open on the virtual machine. They are open in Excel and they're ready to be used. So the next portion here is copying information from the file we downloaded into our macro enabled workbook. So we have some actions here. First, what we need to do is understand what exactly are we copying. There could be only specific portions of the worksheet that we need to copy, maybe not all of it. But in our case, we do want to copy all of it, so we need to understand what is the end of the range of data that we're going to copy. So we use a find range end action. And you'll notice how it's configured here. We are starting from A1, the very first cell, and we're going to find all of the columns and rows, and it's going to output as the range end. So in this case, we are outputting the end of all the rows. So in my case, it's going to be like 22 rows. Once we understand what the end is or how many rows of data we're going to have, then we're going to do a copy and paste. Now this copy and paste action uses a license required. You'll notice we have a starting cell, A1. We're going to paste it into a different workbook, and that specific workbook is located here, which is a file path to the workbook. What sheet are we going to paste in, and where are we going to start? So in this case, we're going to paste starting in A1. Now you'll notice that the ending cell of what we're going to copy, starting from A1 and then ending at that range end, right? So when we incorporate this copy and paste Excel action, we want to make sure we have a starting and ending cell for what it's going to copy. Now, one thing you want to pay particular attention to is, what are we copying? Now, we're not telling this action which workbook to copy from. It's going to automatically copy from whichever workbook is the current primary workbook on screen. So you want to make sure that when you open your workbooks in this first step here, you are opening the workbook that you're going to copy from last, because that workbook is going to be the primary workbook on screen at that time. And when we go down to this close workbook action, it's going to close that primary workbook. So that's why we want to make sure we do these things in a particular order, so that way it works out the way we want when it runs on the VM. So finally, we have copied the data, we have pasted it into our template, our macro enable template, and now we're going to close this workbook because we don't need it anymore. All right, and now we're going to run the macro on the template. So once again, the primary workbook is now the template because we have closed the Excel file workbook. And because it is now the primary, it will run the macro on that primary. So we use a run macro Excel action. In this case, the name of my macro is format Excel file. Then it's going to save that workbook as. So it's going to save it as a separate workbook. Specifically, it's going to save it as an XLSX file. And it's going to replace the existing workbook in that same file location. So it's just going to replace the original Excel file I had downloaded. Now, the file that it replaces is the old pre-formatted version, and it's going to replace it with this new macro formatted version. Once that has happened, we're going to go ahead and close that workbook. So now both workbooks are now closed, and now we can upload that formatted Excel file back to Appian. The last thing to do here is delete that Excel file from the VM, bringing our VM back to an original state. So that way, when we run this, it will be able to do it again and again and again and not have excess files saved in the location of the wherever we're saving it on the VM. So let's go ahead and see an example of this playing out. I'm going to go ahead and rearrange my screen here. Let's bring in a VM. And let me just go ahead and change my window size here. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and run a test. I'll do debugging mode so you can see it happen live over here on the right. All right. So watch the right side here. Watch my VM. I'm going to go ahead and do next action. So it's now going to download that Excel file from wherever it is. There it is. It is now located on my desktop. Next action, it's going to go ahead and get the Excel file name. You'll see that hosted here in the process variable. Now we're going to open both of those Excel workbooks. Next action. So it's going to open the first one, which will be my macro template. So this is a blank template, which is a macro enabled workbook. Next action, now we're opening the file that I had downloaded. So you can see that how the data appears on this. It's fine, but our organization wants this to be formatted in a more specific way. So whether your data is super ugly, it came from external systems and databases, and the format of that data isn't exactly what you're looking for, perhaps you run a macro on it just to get it to the way you want. So that's what we're going to do here. So next action, I'm now going to copy and paste this data from the file I downloaded to my macro enabled template. So next action, it's now going to copy. It is now copied. I am now going to go ahead and paste it into my template workbook. Once it is now pasted into the template workbook, I'm now going to close this main workbook, as we'll no longer need it. And now that it's closed, now you'll notice we're now going down. We're running the macro. The macro has now run. It has now saved the workbook as a separate XLSX workbook. And now we're going to close this workbook. And the final step is uploading the document to Appian. Okay, we're going to do the cleanup section now, which is going to delete this file from the VM. Okay. So now that the file is deleted from the VM, let's go look at our end result. I'm going to go back to my application, to my documents folder, which is where I'm saving that document. And you'll notice there it is. Now I named my file formatted, so it's a little bit easier to see. But now that it's in Appian, perhaps we use this in a process model, perhaps it's part of a larger end-to-end workflow, where it now sends this document as an email or maybe to another file sharing service. Who knows, but we were able to get this file downloaded onto a VM, a macro to update that data and format it, and then take a new file and upload it back to Appian. Don't forget to check out our other great Appian RPA videos, including our courses on Academy Online, and I'll see you in the next one.